In this video, we shall discuss how to calculate income from house property without pre-construction interest adjustment. Calculation of income house property, if I am going to explain in a single video, the length of the video will be too long. So what I have done is, I have already uploaded a video for how to calculate annual value. And in this video, I will be explaining how to calculate house property income without the pre-construction interest. Another video I have uploaded how to calculate pre-construction interest. So all the links I am giving it in the description box. So do watch that video also for a better understanding of this chapter. Now moving into this video, first I'll explain you the format. What are the items that you have to deduct after calculating annual value? For calculating annual value, you look into the description box. I have given the link. Now, after calculating this step, after calculating annual value, how to calculate income from house property? We have to claim three deductions, only these three deductions. One is standard deduction, interest on loan, pre-construction interest. If we deduct these three values from the annual value, the answer that we get is income from house property. Okay, so the first deduction is standard deduction. How to calculate the standard deduction? This standard deduction can be claimed at 30% of annual value. Whatever answer that you have here as annual value, on that value you are going to claim 30%. Then interest on loan. If the property is constructed out of an money borrowed, then interest paid on that loan amount can be claimed as a deduction. This value will be given in the question. Then pre-construction interest, I am uploading another video. You watch that video about what is pre-construction interest. You have to calculate this and write the amount in the inner column, add all these three values, bring it to the outer column, deduct it from annual value, you will get income from house property. So this is the format. Now, before going to the problems, I will give you a small recap about what is a let out property, self-occupied property, which I have already explained in my other videos. So a let out property is, if the owner is giving the property for rent, then it is called as a let out property and it is taxable under the head income from house property. Then if the property is used by the owner for his own residential purpose, then that is called as a self-occupied property. It is also taxable under the head income from house property. If the property is used by the owner for his business purpose or for carrying out his profession, then that house will not be considered under house property at all. We will not calculate income from house property for that house. Okay, and I have explained you the format. Just now I told you a format for calculating house property, that is for a let out house. What I told you, the three deductions, standard deduction, interest on loan, pre-construction interest, that format is for a let out property. Then how will we calculate for a self-occupied property? For a self-occupied property, the annual value is always nil. The annual value of a self-occupied property is always nil. You cannot claim standard deduction. You can claim only interest on loan and pre-construction interest. Okay, only for a let out property, we will claim standard deduction, interest on loan, pre-construction interest. For a self-occupied property, we can claim only interest on loan and pre-construction interest. The annual value is nil. Okay, if you see it with examples, with example problems, you will understand it. First, I am starting with a simple problem. Mr. Ram owns a house property. The fair rent of the property is 80,000. The house was let out to a tenant on a monthly rent of rupees 7,000. He claimed the following expenses: municipal tax 8,000, expenses for recovery of rent 600, fire insurance premium 500. The house remained vacant for 1 month during the previous year. Find his income under house property. Okay, the first thing that you should do as soon as you see a house property problem is see how many houses are given. In this question, he owns a house property. A house means he owns one single house and it is not divided. It is not given that the house is divided into subunits. So one house, and what is he using the house? the house was let out to a tenant. So this is a let out property. He is letting out the property to a tenant. It is a let out property. So for a let out property, we have to calculate annual value. For calculating annual value, we should first compare with municipal value. Municipal value is not given. The next is fair rent. See, fair rent is given. Fair rent of the property is 80,000. So I am writing 80,000 in the inner column. Then we have to compare with standard rent. Standard rent is not given in the question. So the next value is actual rent. The actual rent is 7,000. This is a monthly rent. It was let out to a tenant on a monthly rent of rupees 7,000. So we have to convert it into per annum. So 7,000 into 12. But before multiplying by 12, you have to check if the house is vacant. See, the house remained vacant for 1 month. So out of 12 months, the house remained vacant for 1 month. So we are receiving rent only for 11 months. That is why I have multiplied it with 11. So always before multiplying by 12, you have to check for vacancy. If the house is vacant, reduce the number of months the house was vacant. Okay. So 7,000 into 11, you will get 77,000. So since the house is vacant, normally we will compare and take the highest value. But since the house is vacant, whatever is the actual rent, that will be the gross annual value. Don't compare. If the house is vacant, don't compare. Whatever is the gross and so whatever is the actual rent, that will be the gross annual value. From the gross annual value, deduct municipal tax. Look into the question. Municipal tax is 8,000 rupees. So I am writing 8,000 in the inner column. Deducting it from the gross annual value, the annual value that I get is 72,000. So after calculating annual value, we can claim three deduction. Standard deduction, interest on loan, pre-construction interest. First, we'll start with standard deduction. How to calculate standard deduction? Whatever answer you have here as annual value, on that answer you will claim 30%. So 72,000 into 30%, 21,600. The next is interest on loan. Check in the question, is interest on loan given? No interest on loan given. So we cannot claim it. Pre-construction interest is also not there. That also we cannot claim. But there are certain other items. Expenses for recovery of rent, fire insurance premium. All these are given, but you don't claim it. We can claim only three deduction. Standard deduction, interest on loan, pre-construction interest. Standard deduction is whatever is the annual value. On the annual value, you claim 30%. For interest on loan, if it is given, we can claim. For pre-construction interest also, if it is given, we can claim. Otherwise, we cannot claim any other expenses. So in this question, we have only standard deduction. Deduct it from the annual value, you will get income from house property. So this is a very simple problem of calculating income from house property. Better. See, this is the first question that I have taken. Mr. Harish is a member of an housing cooperative society in Delhi and resides in half the portion of the house under hire purchase scheme. The remaining half is let out at 2,000 per month. The fair rent of the house assessed by the corporation is 30,000 per annum. Local taxes paid in respect of the house is 12,000. Expenses incurred include fire insurance premium and ground rent. Interest payable to the society is 16,000. Compute income from house property. So as soon as you see a problem under house property, you should first decide how many houses are given. So look into the question, how many houses are given? It is given as he resides in half the portion of the house. The house. So this is a singular term. That means only one house is given. And the house is not used as a single house. He owns one house and the house is divided. How did I come to this conclusion? Because it is given that he resides in half the portion. He is using only half the portion of the house. So I came to the conclusion that the house is divided. Okay. Now, what is the unit 1 used for? Unit 1 is used for his own residence. Resides in half the portion. So I already told you, if the owner uses the house for his own residential purpose, it is called as a self-occupied house. Unit 1 is self-occupied. Okay, then the remaining half portion is let out. So unit 2, what happens to unit 2? It is let out. The owner is giving the rent at the house for rent. So this is a let out property. Okay, after deciding this, we should see the proportion. One house is divided into two units. So what is the floor area occupied by each unit? It is given clearly that half portion. Here again it is given half portion. So one house is divided into equal halves. So the proportionate floor area occupied is 50%. Only if you understand this better, your answer will come correct. Otherwise, house property chapter is very simple. Only three deductions. If you claim those three deductions, you will get your answer correct. But if you have a clarity with this only, you will be able to work out the answer correctly. Okay, after deciding this, I will move on to the answer. I will start my answer with unit 1. Unit 1 is self-occupied. So I have written it here in the particulars column, self-occupied, and the floor area of the self-occupied house is 50%. As I already told you, the annual value of a self-occupied house is always nil. We don't have any annual value because we don't have any income from that self-occupied house. Only if you have income, you will calculate annual value. So here the annual value is nil. Now, what are the deductions that you can claim? Interest on loan, pre-construction interest. Only two deductions that you can claim. See, interest on loan, it is given in the question. Interest payable to the society is 16,000 rupees. So interest on loan, I have calculated 60,000 into 50%. Why have I done this 50%? Because one house, the interest for this one house is 16,000. This whole house interest is 16,000. I want to know what is the interest for the self-occupied house. So I am dividing this interest into 50/100 because 50% is the floor space occupied by the self-occupied house. Hope you understand this. The house is divided into units. The interest paid for the whole house is 16,000. I want to know how much is the interest for the self-occupied portion alone. That is why I am dividing it by 50%. So the answer that I get is 8,000. From 0, nil means 0. From 0, if I deduct 8,000, what will be my answer? My answer will be minus 8,000. This minus 8,000 is a loss from the self-occupied house. Okay, then I'm moving on to the let-out portion. The let-out portion is 50% of the floor space. Okay, I have to calculate annual value. For a let-out house, we have to calculate annual value. Only for a self-occupied house, the annual value is nil. Okay, for this let-out house, if I have to calculate annual value, we have to compare municipal value, fair rental value, standard rent, actual rent. But in this question, we have only fair rental value. See, the fair rent of the house is 30,000 rupees. So I have written fair rent here. I don't have municipal value, I skipped it. Okay, the fair rent of the whole house is 30,000 rupees. I am multiplying it by 50% because I want to know what is the fair rental value of this let out portion. This let out portion occupies only 50% of the floor area. So I am calculating it by 50/100. 30,000 is the fair rent for the whole house. I am calculating how much is for the let out portion. So it is 15,000. Okay, after fair rent, we have to compare with standard rent. In this question, standard rent is not given. So I'm moving on to the next value, actual rent. What is the actual rent? The remaining half portion is let out at 2,000 per month. So this is the actual rent. So actual rent is 2,000 multiplied by 12. Why am I multiplying by 12? Because it is a per month rent. So I'm multiplying by 12. To get 1 year value. And another thing which you should note here is, before multiplying by 12, you have to check whether there is any vacancy. Look into the question, is any vacancy given? No, there is no information that the house was vacant. So So I am multiplying by 12. So 2000 into 12 will give me 24,000 rupees. So I will compare and I will take the highest value. I hope you remember the tip which I gave you. If you are comparing with standard rent, take the lowest value. Otherwise, take the highest value. So I am taking the highest value. The highest value is 24,000 and this is called as gross annual value. After calculating gross annual value, we have to deduct municipal tax. How much is the municipal tax that is given? Look, local taxes. Local tax, municipal tax, all means the same thing. So the local tax paid is 12,000. Again, 12,000 is for the whole house. I am trying to calculate how much for the let out portion. So into 50 by 100. The answer that I get is 6,000 rupees. If I deduct municipal tax from the annual value, from the gross annual value, my annual value is 18,000. After calculating annual value, we have to claim standard deduction. As I already told you, standard deduction is nothing but whatever is the annual value. On that annual value, you have to claim 30%. So 18,000 into 30 divided by 100, it will give you 5,400. Then the next deduction is interest on loan. If we have interest on loan, we can claim it. In this question, we have interest payable to the society is 16,000. So interest on loan, 16,000 into 50%, because I want to know only interest of let out portion. So 16,000 into 50 by 100, 8,000 is the interest. I am writing both the deductions in the inner column, adding it, bringing it to the outer column, deducting it from annual value. I am getting the income from let out house. So in the outer column, I have two values. One is loss from self-occupied property. The other is income from let out property. From income, I am deducting the loss. I am arriving at a further loss of 3,400, which is the answer. In this problem, we don't have income. We have loss from house property. I hope you understood this problem. I have taken another example also. See, this is the question. Mr. Naresh owns a big house consisting of two units. One unit is let out for residential purpose on a monthly rent of 2000. However, this unit remained vacant for 3 months during the previous year when it was used by Naresh for his own residential purpose. The second unit half portion is used by him for his own profession while the remaining half portion is used for his own residence. His expenses, municipal tax, 20% of municipal value, repairs, interest on loan for the renewal of the house, ground rent, fire insurance premium, annual charge. So with this information, we have to calculate income from house property. So as usual, your first step is you have to see how many houses are given. See, owns a big house. A big house means singular, one house. And the house consists of two units. So this is what I've given here, one house. It is divided into two units. This is unit 1 and this is unit 2. Okay. One unit is let out for residential purpose. So this is a let out property. Unit 1 is let out on a monthly rent of 2000. Okay. Then the second unit half portion. That means second unit half portion. That means second unit is again divided into 2. Okay, second unit, half portion is used by him for his own profession. So in the second unit, half portion is used by him for his own profession, while the remaining half portion is used for his own residence. So the remaining half portion, he is using it for self-occupation, for his self-occupation purpose. I will explain this once again. He owns one big house. And the house consists of two units. So one house, we are dividing it into two units. One unit is let out. So one unit is a let out property. Then the other unit, the second unit half portion is given. That means second unit is again divided into two units. And one half is used for his profession and the other half is self-occupied property. So that is what I have written here. And then we have to see the floor space occupied. No floor space occupied is given. So we are assuming that The house is first divided into equal half. Equal half means 50%. Unit 1 is 50%, unit 2 is 50%. And again, unit 2 is divided equally. If you divide 50% equally, you will get 25%, and again 1, 25%. Hope you understood this calculation. Yes? Okay, now moving on to the answer. I am starting the answer with the let out property. For calculating let out property, you should first calculate annual value. For calculating annual value, we should start with municipal value. Look for the question. Municipal value is not given directly, but it is given that municipal taxes is 10,000 at 20% of municipal value. This is what is given. How will we normally calculate municipal tax? Municipal tax is equal to municipal value into 20%. This is how we will normally calculate municipal tax. Now we will substitute values. Municipal tax is 10,000, right? 10,000. Into 100 divided by, a step is missing here. If you substitute values, municipal tax is 10,000. Municipal tax is 10,000 is equal to, we don't know what is municipal value, into 20 by 100. So, this is the formula, into 20 by 100. Now, municipal value, I am keeping it here itself after the equal to, and I am bringing this 20 by 100 beyond this sign, beyond the equal to sign. If I bring this beyond the equal to sign, what will happen? Denominator will become the numerator and numerator will become the denominator. So 10,000 into 100 divided by 20 is equal to municipal value. If you multiply this, you will get 50,000. 50,000 will be your municipal value. So municipal value is 50,000, which is for the whole house. We are calculating how much for the let out portion. The floor space occupied by the let out portion is 50%. So multiply, the answer that you get is 25,000. Then fair rent is not given in the question. Standard rent is also not given. So moving on to the next value, actual rent. See, it is given that the house is let out on a monthly rent of 2,000. Monthly rent, so 2,000 into 12. But I already told you, before multiplying by 12, you have to check for vacancy. See, this unit remained vacant for 3 months. The house was vacant for 3 months. So, you should not multiply by 12. Instead, 12 minus 3. Because we did not receive rent for 3 months. We received rent only for 9 months. 3 months we did not receive out of 12 months. So, how much months we received rent? Only for 9 months. So, 2000 into 9, 18,000. And during the previous year, when it was used by Naresh Kumar for his own residential purpose, so the house was vacant, and during the vacancy period, the house was used by Naresh Kumar. So, the vacancy provision will not apply here. We will take only whichever is high. Only if the house is vacant during the vacancy period, whatever is the actual rent, that will be the gross annual value. But since Naresh Kumar is using the house for his own residential purpose, whichever is high will be the gross annual value. After this, you have to deduct municipal tax. Municipal tax is 10,000 rupees. On 10,000, we are calculating 50%. So 5,000 is the municipal tax. If you deduct 5,000, annual value is 20,000. After calculating annual value, you have to claim standard deduction. Standard deduction is nothing but whatever is your annual value. On that annual value, you have to claim 30%. So annual value is 20,000 into 30 by 100 will give you 6,000 rupees. Then you have to claim interest on loan. See, in this question, there is interest on loan. Interest on loan for renewal of the house is 20,000. So 20,000 into 50%, you will get 10,000. Totally 16,000 if you deduct from annual value. The income from let out property is 4,000 rupees. So for dividing this 50% floor space division, I will give you one tip. You have to divide this floor space division for all values. Except for what values you will not divide is, actual rent and standard deduction. Actual rent and standard deduction ku mattum you will not apply this 50%, the floor area division, that you will not do. Apart from that, all the other values you have to apply. Okay, now self-occupied house. What is the proportion for self-occupied house? See, we have decided it is 25%. So I have given it here 25%. The annual value of a self-occupied house is always nil. So we have written nil in the inner column. The two deductions that you can claim for a self-occupied house is interest on loan and pre-construction interest. So interest on loan 20,000 into 25%, 5,000 rupees. From zero, if you deduct 5,000 rupees, you will get minus 5,000. Okay. Okay. Now we have calculated this let out portion and we have calculated the self-occupied portion, and we will not calculate this professional part of the house, because as I already told you, if a house is used for business or profession, then it will not come under the head house property. So we have calculated only for the let out portion and the self-occupied portion. We have an income from let out property, a loss from a self-occupied property. If we deduct loss from income, you have a further loss of 1,000 rupees in this problem. So I hope you understood how to calculate income from house property without pre-construction adjustment. Thank you for watching.